Hi and welcome to the 2012 edition of WPHS. I'm Kenzie Colvar.
And I'm Kiowa Weezer-Matthews.
Great to be here, Kiowa. I'm Chad Hoffman.
And I'm Evan Nodsley. Have you ever wanted to be a ninja? Well, our field team of Joe and Cody are figuring out what it is like to be one.
Hey guys! I saw some guy doing awesome ninja moves just right out.
Alright, awesome!
I know, right?
Do this!
Yeah! Check this out.
Alright, and now
hey Cody! Check this out, I'm about to run up the wall! Okay. Yeah, I think we need training.
Yeah. The Master's Dojo.
Very informative. We might actually have a chance at this.
Yes, it would.
Yeah, let's go.
Thank you, Joe and Cody. That was certainly interesting.
Those ninjas sure are limber, aren't they, Ivan?
And docile.
Quite. Some of the teachers in WPHS seem to be a little bit of downers. Now why don't we turn those frowns upside down and get some music benefiting our favorite local staff.
It's a very, very mad world.
Wow, what a great story. Next week, we will be meeting with some seniors to learn about one of Perm High School's oldest problems. Now, our next clip is a silly tale regarding our school's water fountain placements and the tale of three men.
I don't know, just because I want to start doing my own stunts. Tumble down a rocky edge and take a bath and I see a piranha.
Water. Water. Water.
All right, next week, we will be interviewing and looking into the lives of the people that clean our school. Wow, what a great tale of water fountains, right, Kiowa?
Right you are, Chad. Now let's go to the school for a closer look at the making of Perm High School's fan base.
Good fans really set the tempo for a great game.
We're the best cheering section in the state.
The hive is where it's at.
It fuels me for the game.
Our student section is what makes us the school of champions.
The roar of the crowd really just, it's an inspiration to just play harder and beat the team that we are playing.
All right, what do you think about the support this year and what it means to us?
Well, the support has been overwhelming this year. It's probably been, I talked to Fred Zeeler, the athletic director, and he said it was a record number already this year with only three home games for us, record crowd on pace if we keep our current attendance. So that means a lot to our team to come out and see the support we've had. Even on the road, we've had a lot of people coming and watching us, and I think it's going to make a big influence down the stretch how good we do.
We are here in this empty, desolate beehive. In mere hours, this hive will attract hundreds of bees arriving home after a hard day of pollinating.
This place, as you can see, has been overtaken by hundreds of bees. It is getting rather rowdy, and bodies are piling up by the minute. As we can see, some bees are getting up to perform rituals to attract females of the opposite sex.
Define the beehive.
I don't know what the beehive is.
That the beehive influences the games.
Absolutely.
Why? Or how?
Well, it's a home crowd, home court advantage, so if you got the fans on your side and it's a loud, noisy gymnasium, it's only going to help the home team.
Wow, what huge school spirit for such a small town. It's going to be a long winter. Knack, aka Carly, Naoto, Annie, Candace, and Kenzie will show you how to fight those winter blues.
Gills.
Hi.
What's the matter?
Well, it's this midwinter blues thing. It is really getting me down.
I know what you're saying with all this hard classes and such, but, you know, cheer up, buddy. If only I knew how. I hear you ladies need a problem solver to help you with your midwinter blues.
Sure do.
Do you know what I have store for you?
What?
A plan to help you smile your way through the winter days.
Yay!
Solution number one. How to solve the midwinter blues with a snow fight. Embrace the snow with no ice. Solution number two, pick up a new hobby. Hannah and Jordan, what's your hobby?
Sewing.
I just love sewing. It's real great in the winter. It helps with my arthritis.
Yeah, it keeps your fingers nice and nimble.
Solution number three, connect with nature. Pet an animal. Four.
Get your groove on.
The next thing that you can do to help fight the midwinter blues is take a nap.
Newton's awesome.
You can play Minecraft to help beat the midwinter blues.
Or you can hug people. With all this homework, I'm pretty stressed out.
Guys!
Almost done!
But one way to fight the midwinter blues is to stop procrastinating.
Those are some ways to solve midwinter blues.
Happy freezing!
Next week, Knack will go underground. What do you think about that, Kenzie?
Another great point, Kiowa. Ever wonder the life of the average student? Watch his day, dawn to dusk.
This is Ted Bear, and today we're stalking Brian, the most elusive of the PHS students. Fascinating. Today we observe Brian in his natural habitat. Oh, he seems to have spotted some predators. A victorious day for Brian. Brian often places the visage of dangerous creatures to frighten off possible threats to his territory.
Hey, you know where Mr. Zimmerman is?
Yeah, sure. Hold on, I'll check. He's in his office.
Okay, thanks.
A solitary creature, Brian has an aversion to the company of others.
Whoa.
truly a majestic creature.
You're right, it is a cosmic cat.
Totally.
What?
That's
okay. Dude, what's wrong with Shane?
Dude, what do you mean?
Well, look at him. He's not even touching them today.
You're right. His hands? His feet? He's not even sitting. He's just floating there.
Shane, are you alright?
Tune in next week as guest star Rob Reiner shares with us the secret of life. From WPHS, I'm Kenzie Colbar.
And I'm Kyle Weezer Matthews.
I'm Chad Hofflin. Thanks for stopping by.
And I'm Ivan Nodsley. You stay classy, Pertham High School.
But mostly, thanks for stopping by.